गुड आफ्टरनून ऑल. ओके, ड्यू टू सम नेटवर्क इश्यूज आई हैव जॉइंड लेट. ओके ओके, नाउ इन दिस सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस रिलेटेड टू द अल्ट्रासोनिक वेल्डिंग ऑफ द प्लास्टिक मटेरियल्स एंड फ्रिक्शन वेल्डिंग ऑफ द प्लास्टिक मटेरियल्स. ओके, अल्ट्रासोनिक वेल्डिंग ऑफ प्लास्टिक मटेरियल्स एंड फ्रिक्शन वेल्डिंग ऑफ प्लास्टिक मटेरियल्स. नाउ टू अंडरस्टैंड द अल्ट्रासोनिक वेल्डिंग, नाउ हियर द बेसिक पॉइंट यू हैव टू note that in the ultrasonic welding, okay, here we are going to use the mechanical vibration to create the joint or to form the joint between the plastic parts or to join the two plastic parts. We are using the mechanical vibration, okay, and these vibrations are with very high frequency vibrations we are using here to make the joint between two plastic parts. Okay, now the basic concept will be like this. Here, whichever part you want to join, okay, the parts to be assembled. Okay, assembled means whichever plastic parts you want to join together under the pressure between the oscillating horn and an immobile anvil. Okay, these are subjected to the ultrasonic vibrations of frequency 20 to 40 kilohertz. At right angles to the contact area. I will explain it with the help of diagram. Then, okay, this is wait. In this presentation, I have that diagram, working diagram. Okay, so this is the basic principle here. Ultrasonic welding. This is the ultrasonic welding of the plastics. This is the diagram, working diagram, or you can put it the working principle of the ultrasonic welding. Okay. Now here, what we are going to do, this is the anvil. Okay, this is the anvil and this is the oscillating horn. Okay, some vibrations will be there. This oscillating horn, it will vibrate with very high frequency, 20 to 40 kilohertz. These are the two plastic parts. This is the anvil. In between these horn, oscillating horn and the anvil. This is the anvil is nothing but a support on which we are keeping the plastic materials to be joined. And with the help of this horn, oscillating horn, we are going to provide the mechanical vibrations on this plastic material. These are two plastic materials. This horn will create, oscillating horn will create the mechanical vibration. Now, what will happen due to this mechanical vibration? Okay, here it is explained in this ultrasonic welding process. What actually will happen? Okay, before this will happen here. Before discussing this, what will happen when this vibration means or this oscillating horn will come in contact with that plastic material? Before that, how this how the oscillations are created or mechanical vibrations are created horn. That's the diagram, okay? Whichever arrangement is here and is shown here only. So what is the work of this transducer? Okay, what is the work of this transducer that I have explained here? Okay, this is the horn, this last blue the horn. And before the, here we have used one transducer. Then this converter is the low power into frequency power to and this high electric power transducer, and the transducer will high frequency electric power vibration or in the vibrating energy. Okay, this transducer, what is the work of this transducer? It will convert the high frequency electric power, which is the frequency converter, into the वाइब्रेटिंग एनर्जी और जस्ट यू कैन से दैट द मैकेनिकल वाइब्रेशंस एंड दैट इज एंड इट विल दिस हॉर्न थ्रू दिस हॉर्न दैट मैकेनिकल वाइब्रेशंस आर गिवन टू दी प्लास्टिक मटेरियल फॉर वेल्डिंग प्रोसेस. नाउ व्हेन दिस हॉर्न दिस ऑसिलेटिंग हॉर्न व्हेन इट कम्स विद द प्लास्टिक मटेरियल व्हाट एग्जैक्टली हैपन्स. ओके दिस इज द प्लास्टिक हॉर्न इट इज वाइब्रेटिंग विद वेरी हाई फ्रिक्वेंसी. It is vibrating with a very high frequency. Okay, this horn applies the pressure to the plastic material. This is the plastic material. These are the plastic materials to be joined. When this horn or this oscillating horn will come in contact with this plastic material, it applies the pressure. Then this horn vibrates vertically. Okay, it vibrates vertically in this direction. Okay, its vibrations will be in vertical direction. And its speed is, you can say that, to 20,000 to 40,000 per second. Okay. Then, due to this high frequency vibrations, what will happen? It will create the frictional heat. Friction will be there between this oscillating horn and that plastic material. And due to this friction, heat will be generated. And due to this heat, these material, plastic material, starts melting. Okay, they will melt and flow together. They will melt and flow together. And here, during this melt, when it will melt, due to this vibration, pressure will be applied. And when you allow to cool them, they will form the joint. Okay, they will form the joint or bond will get created in this plastic material. So, this is the basic working principle. Basic working principle of the ultrasonic welding process. Okay. I will repeat it again. Okay, due to this oscillating horn or this vibrating horn, high frequency oscillations or that vibrations are given to the plastic material. These plastic materials are held with the help of anvil. These are held in between the anvil and that oscillating horn. That oscillating horn will give the vibrations and it will also apply the pressure. They will vibrate vertically, and due to that continuous vibrations of a high frequency, about 20 to 40 kilohertz, and due to that pressure, due to that horn, that plastic material starts melting and they will get joined due to the pressure of that horn. Okay, in this way, okay, this is the first. The horn applies pressure to the plastic material, then horn vibrates vertically with very high vibrations, 20,000 to 40,000 times per second, and due to this high frequency vibrations, frictional heat causes the material to melt. And due to this melting, they will flow together. And after some time, they will cool and they will form a joint. After the cooling process, that firm joint will be formed. In this way, the two different plastic materials will get joined with the help of ultrasonic welding. Okay. This is the concept of ultrasonic welding. That this only is explained in these first 3 points. Okay, the parts to be assembled are held together under the pressure between the oscillating horn and immobile anvil. Anvil is fixed, and these are subjected to the ultrasonic vibrations with very high frequency. Okay, 20 to 40 kilohertz high frequency at right angles to that plastic surface. This direction of that vibration or that vibration frequency will be at right angle. Okay, then alternating high frequency stresses generates the heat. Okay, due to that continuous vibration, it causes the friction and heat is generated, and that material starts melting and they will get joined. Okay, now this ultrasonic welding is divided in two types: near field ultrasonic welding and far field ultrasonic welding. What is the meaning of near field ultrasonic welding? In the near, this classification is done on the basis of the distance बिटवीन द हॉर्न एंड वेल्ड इंटरफेस, कि डिस्टेंस बिटवीन द हॉर्न एंड द वेल्ड इंटरफेस, कि दिस इज दी वेल्ड इंटरफेस, दिस जॉइंट, कि फ्रॉम दिस जॉइंट दिस टू मटेरियल्स विल गेट जॉइंट एट दिस पॉइंट, दिस इज दी वेल्ड इंटरफेस एंड डिस्टेंस बिटवीन दिस टिप ऑफ दिस हॉर्न एंड दैट वेल्ड इंटरफेस डिपेंडिंग ऑन इट टू टाइप्स आर देयर, नियर फील्ड अल्ट्रासोनिक वेल्डिंग एंड फार फील्ड अल्ट्रासोनिक वेल्डिंग. व्हेन द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन द हॉर्न एंड वेल्ड इंटरफेस इज लेस देन 6 मिलीमीटर, इट इज टर्म्ड एज नियर फील्ड अल्ट्रासोनिक वेल्डिंग. एंड व्हेन द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन द हॉर्न एंड वेल्ड इंटरफेस इज ग्रेटर और मोर देन दैट 6 मिलीमीटर, देन इट विल बी टर्म्ड एज फार फील्ड अल्ट्रासोनिक वेल्डिंग. Okay, this is the far field ultrasonic welding. Please note that this is okay. Distance between this, please see this carefully. This is the horn, tip of this horn or end of this horn, and this is the weld interface. Okay, this is the weld interface. Distance between this horn and weld interface, near field and far field ultrasonic welding. When distance between horn and this weld interface is less than 6 millimeter. It is near field ultrasonic welding, and when distance is more than 6 millimeter, then it is termed as far field ultrasonic welding. Okay. Then we will move towards some application point, advantages and disadvantages point. Okay. Now, some advantages here I have highlighted here, used in the mass production. Okay. This ultrasonic welding method is used in the mass production, as this ultrasonic welding can be completed with minimum time, or its cycle time is very low. Okay, heating is done with very faster rate. That's why it results in the low cycle time. That's why this process can be, you can say that it will can be helpful to do the mass production. Then this can be applied to both types of the thermoplastics, that is amorphous thermoplastics and semi-crystalline thermoplastics, and this can be used to join the dissimilar plastic material also. Okay, dissimilar plastic materials also can be joined. Okay, you can join polyethylene to the polypropylene like that. Okay, different or dissimilar plastic materials can be joined together with the help of this ultrasonic welding. Then what is the limitation here? Now, limitation is related to the horn size. Okay, depending on your design, design of that plastic part or design of whichever joint you want, type of the joint, depending on that, here you have to design the horn, and it is having certain limitation. It has certain limitation to the design. Okay, so design related to the that horn or tools, these are restricted. You have to change it according to the that weld type of the weld. Now where it is used? Now this ultrasonic welding process is used for in the food packaging. Okay, different types of the packaging plastics are there which we are using in the food packaging. There we are using to join that, we are using this ultrasonic welding process only, and different computer components are joined with the help of this ultrasonic welding only. And another application is disposable. Okay, this is the disposable lighter. I have collected that just okay. For joining this disposable butane lighters, for joining this disposable butane lighters we are using for joining this. Okay, to join this disposable butane lighters, this ultrasonic welding is used. So these are the applications of ultrasonic welding. Then after this ultrasonic welding, we will move towards the next type, that is the friction welding. Okay, here I will wait for some time. Please draw this diagram. If you are having any difficulty, you can ask me. complete the drawing. Please draw this diagram showing the working principle of the ultrasonic welding. If you have completed this, I will move towards the friction welding. Okay, this is the friction welding. Okay, this is the friction welding process. Okay, here they have explained the concept. One minute, I will collect one diagram here so that you will understand it clearly. This is the concept here. You will be able to see this is the before going for this process. I will explain a few points here. This friction welding of the thermoplastic. Okay, it is also known as the spin welding. Okay, this is also known as the spin welding. Spin welding, you can say that it is one of the type of this friction welding only. But for the generally used for joining of these plastic parts, we are generally using the spin welding only. Okay. Now, in this process, substrate is nothing but your parts to be joined, or you can say that your workpiece. Now, once substrate is fixed, here you will be able to see this is the one surface, it is fixed, and the other substrate or other workpiece. One workpiece is fixed, or one substrate is fixed, and other workpiece or other substrate is rotating. Okay, rotating with controlled angular velocity. Okay, with controllable angular velocity, it is rotating. Then when part, what will you will do? The one is fixed, other is rotating, and after that, these parts are placed together. Okay, one part is fixed, another is rotating, and these two parts are pressed together. Then what will happen due to this friction? There will be some friction and it produces some heat. As one part is fixed and it is another is rotating, and we have applied the pressure. Okay, from both sides we are applying the pressure. Then due to the friction, their frictional heat will get created. And due to that frictional heat, that polymer or that plastic material starts melting, and after sufficient time it will get cooled and a weld or joint is formed. So this is the friction welding method, and this same friction welding method is explained here in this diagram. Okay, this is the first, this is the one workpiece, and this is the another workpiece. One workpiece or one substrate is rotating. one work piece or one substrate is rotating and another work piece or your substrate is fixed. This is the fixed one. In the first, this is the first stage. In the second stage, what we are going to do here, a pressure is applied. Okay. From both sides, pressure is applied. Means this rotating part and fixed part, we are forcing against each other. These are forced against each other. Then what will happen at this point? Okay, due to the friction, you can say that frictional heat is created and plastic material starts melting. It starts melting and they will get joined after the cooling. In this way, the joint is formed here. Okay, joint is formed. This is the friction welding method, or this is the concept or working principle of the friction welding process. I will repeat it again. Two work pieces which we want to join together, these are taken, and one will be collected or taken in the form of a rotating work piece, or it is in the rotating state, and one work piece is in the fixed state. With the help of one fixture, you can fix it. Then in the second stage, that rotating work piece and fixed work piece, these are pressed against each other. These are pressed, just we are pressing them against each other. It is rotating and it is fixed, and now we are pressing them against each other, and due to this frictional heat will be generated. Okay, at this spot frictional heat will get generated and the plastic material starts melting, and after sufficient cooling they will form a joint here. After sufficient cooling, joint will be formed. This is termed as the friction welding. This is termed as the friction welding. Now, in this friction welding, the major parameters that you have to control, some four or five parameters that you have to take care of. The first parameter is the rotational speed of that workpiece. Then frictional pressure which you are applying on that material. Then forge pressure. Friction pressure and forge pressure. Forge pressure is nothing but the pressure which you are applying to create the bond. That will be termed as the forge pressure. Then the time taken to form the weld. That weld, it will be termed as the weld time. And burn off length. Burn off length is the length, you can say that, the how much portion has burned and formed the bond between the plastic materials. That will be termed as the burn off length. Here I will show that in this diagram. This colored portion, this will be termed as the burn off length. This is the burn off length. Due to that frictional heat, how much amount or how much length got burned, that will be termed as the burn off length in this friction welding process. This is the concept of the friction welding. Then how this friction welding will occur for the plastic material, and which parameters you have to take into consideration while controlling the friction welding of particular parts. Then this friction welding is classified in four different types: linear friction welding, orbital friction welding, spin friction welding, and angular friction welding. Okay, just this classification is deep. You can see here. Okay, now this is the just depending on the motion of the components, you can see that. Okay, yeah, this is the linear friction welding. Linear friction welding, this is the spin friction welding. Linear friction welding, spin friction welding. Then the third and fourth, you can say that angular friction welding, and this is the orbital friction welding. Depending on the motion here, these different types are there. Just I have highlighted this for understanding of your the direction. Okay, just the take the reference of the direction directions only. This spin friction welding. is the spin friction welding. This is the linear friction welding. Okay, frictional heating will be in linear direction. This is the linear direction, and frictional heat will be in the this circular direction or spin direction. You can say that. And the frictional heat will get created in the angular direction, and frictional heat will get created in the orbital direction. Okay, depending on it, these four types are there. Okay, don't take into consideration the shape of this component. Just I have collected this diagram for your reference. Okay, when that frictional heat's direction is a linear along the length, and that components are joined along the length, it will be linear friction welding. When that components are joined along there, you can say that this circumference, it will be termed as spin welding. If there is certain angle, then it is angular welding. And the fourth is the orbit, along the particular orbit, rotational orbit, then it will be termed as orbital welding. These four types are there. Then this friction welding has certain advantages, disadvantages, and its applications. First, we will discuss related to the applications. This friction welding is used to manufacture the manifolds. Okay, these are the manifolds, and these are used in the automobile industry. These manifolds are joined with the help of this friction welding process. These manifolds are joined with the help of friction welding process. And then what is the advantage of this process? Now, advantage of this process, it is a very simple process, and it will give you very high quality of the weld produced. Whichever weld is produced or joint is produced, it will be in, it is a defect free joint, or it is having very high quality. And related to the disadvantage, you can say that this disadvantage is one of the component. It may be that rotating component, or it may be the fixed component. It should be circular in nature. To perform this friction welding process, the one component should be compulsory, one component should be circular in nature. Okay, this is the disadvantage or limitation. What is the advantage of this process? The high quality weld is produced, the method is very simple, and reproducibility of this process is very high. Okay, means you can perform this process again and again. You can perform this process. What is the limitation? One of the component, means you are using two parts here. One is fixed part and another is the rotating part. One part compulsory, it should be in circular form. It should be in the circular form, otherwise you cannot perform this process. And applications, the manifolds which we are using in the automobile sector, these are manufactured with the help of thermoplastic material only, and they are joined with the help of this ultrasonic welding process only. This friction welding process only. Okay, so in this way we have learned how the friction welding process is conducted, its basic principle, then its types, then parameters which affect the friction welding process, and its advantages, disadvantages, and applications. And after this, we will move towards the next process. That is the laser welding. I will wait for a few minutes here. Please complete the drawing. Okay, this is the diagram for laser welding through transmission laser welding. Please draw this diagram. I will wait for a few minutes here. After that, I will explain this. Draw this diagram for laser welding through transmission laser welding. Please draw the diagram. After that, I will explain it. I think I have provided sufficient time. Just draw the one diagram, okay? This diagram only. Okay, now I will explain it. And before going through this, this is the diagram for through transmission laser welding. Before that, I will explain there are two types of the laser welding which we are using. Generally, we are using for plastic material. Two types are there. After discussing that two types, okay. These two types are depending on the mode through which we are using the laser beam for the welding. The first is the surface heating, and another is the through transmission infrared welding. Okay, through transmission infrared welding. Now, the first here, okay, this is the first surface heating. Surfaces of the components to be joined are heated directly. Okay, surfaces of the components which you want to join are directly heated by infrared lights or laser exposure for sufficient period of the time until they softens or plasticizes or melts or molten layer is formed, usually for within two to ten seconds it starts melting. Okay, surfaces which you want to join or we want to join, these are directly heated with the help of infrared light source or laser source, and when its layers gets melted, we stop the heating. Okay, and yeah, okay, once the surface is fully melted, the infrared or laser tool is withdrawn from that between the parts, and the parts are forced together. Forced together means that melted parts are forced, just we have to apply the pressure and they are forced together, and after this melt is allowed to solidify or cool, the joint is formed. Okay, this is termed, this is the one type of a laser welding, or this is one type of the laser welding. The very much similar concept we are using in the infrared welding. Okay, or you can say that this is very much similar to the infrared welding. I will explain it again. Two surfaces or two parts which we want to join, in between two parts one source will be kept, and from that source either infrared lights, or you can say that the laser lights are allowed. That source is taken, due to that whichever plastic parts are there, their surface starts heating. Okay, due to that laser lights, the surface will start collecting heat and they will start melting. When surfaces are melted, then that source, okay, laser source is taken out, and that two surfaces are pressed against each other, and due to this pressure applied, they will allow to forge. They will forge together after sufficient period of cooling, providing sufficient time for cooling. They will forge together and they will solidify, and a bond will be formed. This is the surface heating laser beam welding. You can say that surface heating laser beam welding. And another is the through transmission infrared. Okay, through transmission infrared welding, or this is also termed as the infrared welding process. Okay, this is also termed as infrared. The surface heating is also termed as infrared welding process. How it is performed, how this infrared welding is performed? Two surfaces are taken which you want to join. Okay, I have collected one more diagram here. Okay. Yes, this is the infrared welding process. Okay, this is the infrared welding process. This come two plastic. Okay, this is two plastic parts here. Components there. These are the two components we want to join. These are held in the fixtures, or one with the help of one tool you have to hold it. Then this heated IR tool to be mistaken from this. Infrared lights will be emitted. Infrared lights will be emitted. This source will be get in between these two plastic components. Then, due to this infrared, these infrareds, these components will get heated. Due to this infrared light waves, these components will get heated, and it will take 2 to 10 seconds to heat the surface, and the surface will start melting. When these two surfaces starts melting, this infrared tool or source is removed. The source is removed. Now these two surfaces are in molten form, or their layer has been molten. Just in the next step, in the steel phase, here the force is applied. These two surfaces are forged together with the help of pressure, and they are provided with this after sufficient cooling. Sufficient time is provided to cool, and after that, this press tooling is released, and unloading is done, and this joined component final product is obtained here. This is the infrared welding process. Now, here in the infrared welding process, heating time, what are the advantages of this process? Heating time is very less, within 2 to 10 seconds, depending on the size of that plastic part. Within 2 to 10 seconds, heating process is completed. Then, whichever joint is created, joint is formed, it is having very good quality, defect-free weld will be created. Then high production rates can be achieved, and you can do the automation in this system or in this process. You can go for automation. I will again repeat some advantages. It is very fast process, as heating is completed within 2 to 10 seconds. You can go for the automation, then high production rates are achieved. These are some advantages of this process, infrared welding process. Just you have these steps will be there. First step is the loading stage, then the melting stage. Melting stage, then again the infrared source, light source is removed by opening this filter, as the opening phase, and again it is sealed. This is the sealing phase, that is the forced joining of the component with the application of the pressure, and unloading is done to get the final or joined component will be obtained here. This is the infrared welding process. These are the steps involved in that process. So this will come in the type, that is the surface heating type of the laser beam welding. The next type is the through transmission laser welding. Now, what is the through transmission infrared welding here? It is based on the concept that passing the laser radiations through one component to be welded while having the second component to absorb the light at the interface. And due to this absorption, it results in the heating and melting of the interface and allows the part to be welded. Now, I will explain these two points. This is the through transmission infrared welding. I will have already explained the infrared welding or surface heating. You can say that infrared welding in that surface heating infrared welding, and this is through transmission infrared welding. In the through transmission infrared welding, whichever two components we are going to join, one component should be compulsory, it should be transparent. It should be transparent to the infrared radiations. It should be transparent to the infrared radiations. Here you can see. Means you will be able to see the infrared here. So that components, how much it got penetrated, how much distance it got penetrated, it should be visible. Then what will happen here? The infrared should pass through that component and it will reach to the surface of second component where it is absorbed on the surface, and that surface got heated and starts melting. It starts melting, then these infrared source is removed, and that are forced, these two surfaces are forced to create the joint, and joint will be created. Okay, then certain advantages are there. This process, as heating is done in very faster way or within very shorter time, this is very fast process. Then weld quality is very good. Then it can also weld unsupported internal walls with complex curvatures. Okay. Internal walls having complex shapes can also be joined here. Then what is the disadvantage? Only one disadvantage is there in this process. Already I have explained it. The two components which you want to join, one component must be transparent to the infrared radiations. One component must be transparent. Okay. Then what are the applications this process can be used to join? Brake fluid reservoirs in automotive marking lights. Okay, these are some applications of this. Can say this is the infrared welding. Okay, laser welding, or you can say that it can be considered as infrared. It here laser here. Okay, source will be different. This will can be termed as laser welding, or it is termed as infrared welding. Okay, and it can be done in two ways. If you are using the laser as a source to provide the heat, it will be termed as laser welding. And if you are using infrared light waves, IR light waves, then it will be termed as that infrared welding, and having divided in two types, that surface heating infrared welding and through translation infrared welding. Okay, then that IR source is kept in between that source two components, and the heating is done, and after the heating that source infrared source is removed, and these two parts will be forced to join, forced to form a bond. Then it is the surface heating. Then through transmission infrared welding, one component should be transparent and another means it is not necessary. It should be transparent in nature. Then this IR waves will heat this surface. Okay, it will be absorbed on this surface, and heating is done on this surface only. Okay, here only. And after removal of that IR source and infrared source, these components are forced to form a bond. Okay. And it is having some advantages. It is a very fast process. And then complex shapes or complex walls can be joined together. Weld quality is very good. And the disadvantage is one of the component should be transparent to that infrared radiations. Applications are some automotive marking lights, then brake reservoirs. Okay, so in this way we have completed this infrared. Okay, I will summarize this session what we have discussed. We have completed the ultrasonic welding process, how it is done applied for the plastic materials. Okay, how the ultrasonic welding is done, how the heating of that material is done, and its applications like disposable butane lighters. And we have learned this friction welding, And after this friction welding, we have learned this infrared welding process. Okay, infrared welding process. Then this is the through transmission infrared welding process. Okay. In this way, we have complete in this today's session. We have learned ultrasonic welding process, friction welding process, and infrared welding process with through transmission infrared welding process. Okay. So those who have joined late, please put your mention your roll number in the chat box. I will stop here. Thank you for attending this session.